Welcome again. Today we start the second part of digital design course, sequential circuits, introduction plus RS and D latches. We already know that logic circuits are broadly classified into two types, combinational logic circuits and sequential logic circuits. And we got familiar with different combinational logic circuits such as adders, code conversion circuits, compare circuits, decoders, encoders, multiplexers, demultiplexers, programmable logic devices such as ROMs, PALs, and PLAs. In any combinational logic circuit, the outputs are function only of the inputs or some of these inputs, while in a sequential circuit, the outputs are functions not only of the circuit inputs, but also of the past behavior of the circuit. Since in sequential circuits, we have a feedback, as you see here, that will participate in generating the next outputs. Here is a comparison table between combinational circuits and sequential circuits. In combinational circuits, outputs are functions only of the present inputs, while in sequential circuits, outputs are functions of both present inputs and present state. In combinational circuits, we do not have feedback path, while in sequential circuits, feedback path is present. No memory elements are required in combinational circuits, while memory elements are required in sequential circuits. A clock signal is not required in combinational circuits, while it is required in sequential circuits. Usually, sequential circuits are more difficult to design. Sequential circuits are classified into two types, synchronous and asynchronous. In synchronous sequential circuits, flip-flops are used to implement the states and a clock signal is used to control the operation. While asynchronous sequential circuits do not use a clock signal, but uses the pulses of the inputs. Next, we move to latches and flip-flops. Latches and flip-flops are the basic elements of storing information. One latch or a flip-flop can store one bit of information. The main difference between latches and the flip-flops that latches operate with enable signal, which is level sensitive, whereas flip-flops are edge sensitive. The output of latches are affected by their inputs as long as the enable signal is asserted. In other words, when they are enabled, their content changes immediately when their inputs change. Flip-flops, on the other hand, have their content change only either at the rising or falling edge of the clock signal. After the rising or falling edge of the clock, the flip-flop content remains constant even if the input changes. Next, we start with latches. Here is the graphic symbol for the SR latch, also known as set reset latch. All latches and the flip-flops are implemented using NOR or NAND gates. You already know that in a NOR gate, if any of the inputs is one, then regardless of the second input, the output always will be zero. And in a NAND gate, if any of the inputs is zero, regardless of the other input, then the output always will be one. This will help us in understanding the circuit behavior. Here is the SR latch implemented using NOR gates. We have two NOR gates. RS are applied to the NOR gates, and there is a feedback from the outputs to the inputs, as you see here. In all latches and the flip-flops, there are two outputs, and each one complement of the other. Here we have a Q and not Q. Here is the characteristic table for the SR flip-flop. If we apply here 0, 0, These are the two cases. Then if Q of T was zero here and not Q of T one, then the output here one, so we'll have here zero. The output of the first NOR gate will be zero, and the output of the second NOR gate will be one. Here is the case. If Q of T is zero, then Q of T plus one, here it is zero. If, however, Q of T was one, here the case, then the output of the second NOR gate will be zero, and zero NOR zero is one, and Q of T plus one will be one. Here is the case. If S and R are 0, 1, here the two cases. Now, if Q of T is zero, when applied to the first NOR gate, will produce on the output zero. Zero, NOR zero will be one. So Q of T plus one will be zero. Here is the case. However, Q of T was one here, means here we will have zero. Zero, NOR zero is one. So Q of T plus one will be zero. Here is the case. Next on SR 1, 0. If Q of T was zero, here is the case. Then, as you see, one here will change the state to zero. Zero nor zero, here we will have one. Q of T plus one will be one. If, however, if Q of T was one, here is the case, then the output of the second NOR gate, one NOR one, will be zero. And here zero or NOR zero will be one. So Q of T plus one will be one. Here is the case. Now, if the inputs S and R are 1, 1, the next state will be undefined, since one of these inputs will affect the behavior of the circuit faster than another. So the next state can be zero or can be one. So we have undefined next state. Now, if you examine the characteristic table for the SR latch, you can note that if S and R are zeros, then the next state equals to the present state, and this is the store state. If S and R are 0, 1, then regardless of the present state, the next state will be zero, and this is called reset. And if S and R are 1, 0, then the next state will be one, regardless of the present state. And this state is called set. So this is why it's called set reset. We have on R1 reset and on S1 set. Now the 1, 1 is undefined state. And this is one disadvantage of SR latch and even flip-flop. We can summarize the characteristic table as shown here in the state table of the SR latch. The difference between the characteristic table and the state table, that in the characteristic table, we have the inputs and the present state in the table, and we find the next state. While in the state table, we have only the inputs and the next state is described by the inputs and present state, as you see here. So on 0, 0, the next state will be equal to the present state. This is store state. On 0, 1, the next state is zero, and this is reset. On 1, 0, set, and 1, 1 is undefined. From the characteristic table, we can obtain the characteristic equation or state equation for the SR latch, as you see here, Q of T plus 1 equals 1 on min terms 1 here, and on min term 4 here, and on min term 5. We can use min terms 6 and 7 as do not care conditions. So Q of T plus 1 equals to S or not RQ of T. Here is the characteristic equation or state equation for the SR latch. Here is the SR latch would enable input. This latch affects the outputs as long as the enable E is maintained at 1. If the enable input is 0, then we have here 0. And as you know, this is the store state. In this case, we haven't any change in the state of the latch. If, however, E is equals to 1, then if R and S are 0, 0, then Q of T plus 1 equals Q of T. This is the store state. On 0, 1, we'll have set state Q of T plus 1 equals 1. On 1, 0, we'll have reset state Q of T plus 1 equals 0. And we already know that on 1, 1, the state is undefined. SR latch can be implemented using NAND gates as well. Here is the circuit for the SR latch with enable input implemented using NAND gates. The main difference is that we have the undefined state on 00. As you see from the characteristic table, on 11 here we have store, Q of T plus 1 equals Q of T. On 10, we have set state. On 01, we have reset state. And on 00, we have undefined states. This is the difference between NAND and NOR implementation. This is the state table of the SR latch using NAND gates. On 11, we have store. On 10, set. On 01, reset, and on 00, undefined state. And again, this latch affects the outputs as long as the enable E is 1. If enable is 0, then we have store state. Please note that we apply here S and here R, unlike the NOR implementation, where we had here R and here S. Next, we move to D-latch. There is one drawback of SR latch, that is the next state value cannot be predicted when both the inputs S and R are 1. We can overcome this difficulty by the latch. It's also called the data latch. Here, D in its normal form is applied with enable to 1 AND gate, and in its complement form would enable input to the second AND gate. As you see, if D is 0, then we will have here 0 and here 1. And this is a reset state, RS. So Q of T plus 1 will be 0. Here if D is 0, Q of T plus 1 will be 0. However, if D is 1 with enable 1, we'll have here 1, here 0, and here 0. 1, 0 means set. And Q of T plus 1 will be 1 here. It's easy to note from the state table of D latch that Q of T plus 1 equals D. This is the characteristic equation for the D latch. Q of T plus 1 equal D. Or with enable input, it is E and D or not E ended with the Q, which means that the latch will function only if the input E enable is 1. It's obvious that if E is 0, then we'll have 0, 0, and Q of T plus 1 is the same as Q of T, here store state. However, if E is 1, then the next state will be equal to D. D-latches and D-flip-flops are mainly used for storage purposes since they store the bit applied to the input. Thank you.